Minister first introduced the GST, he talked about many advantages of GST to the centre, to the nation and to the state, sir. And he said things like reducing of fraud, evasion will go away, compliant chains will come in, it'll be simpler, there'll be less paperwork, removing ambiguity, and it translates into higher revenues and higher revenues for the state and for the nation and the nation growth, sir. However, there were many skeptics, sir, and the skeptics included all the states, and many BJP states themselves were skeptical, sir. And we, on the other hand, sir, we are from a party in the center of the house. We have many things. We had complaints. We felt we were cheated. We felt the center treated us unjust on Kaleshwaram, on Bayaram mines, on AIIMS. We have a whole list, coach factory, and today morning even our own defense land for our purpose of better roads, sir. So in many ways. So there are two things, sir. Either we can complain and fight, or complain and protest, or we can cooperate and hope the center government recognizes and gives us these things, sir. Our chief minister has shown great maturity, sir. And there's a saying in English, sir, if you're angry with somebody, you can cut off your nose and spite the face, sir. Our chief minister is not like that, sir. He saw some of the long-term merits of GST, and we were the very first state in the entire country, even before a BJP state agreed, we passed it in our assembly, and we were the first to sign it, sir. So we look forward for the central government to also assist us in various things, sir. Sir, I'd just like to point out a few things, sir. Firstly, our local things here, and you are the chairman of MP LAT, sir. Sir, 2 years back, we are all looking, there was a small rumor or talks in the central hall that MP lads is badaenge, 10 crore badaenge, 25 crores and all that, sir. And while we are looking up, hopefully that something will go, the GST hit us in the stomach at the bottom, sir. You took off 18% on our MP lads, sir. So effectively, GST reduced our 5 crores MP lads to about 4.1 crores, sir. You removed MP lads, sir. Sir, but that is not the thing, sir. Look at evasion. Is evasion stopped? It's not stopped. Has fraud stopped? No. Is it more efficient? It's definitely not simpler, sir. Kalikesh, the Isagutraji pointed out. Is there less ambiguity? No, sir. There's actually more ambiguity. I'll share a few examples, sir. Starting with what's affecting me in my constituency. A place called Thandur, sir. It's one of the largest producers of blue stone or the Napa Rai or the Shahabad Rai or Thandur Rai, as we call it, sir. It's the cheapest stone. A square foot of that flooring costs about 10 rupees, sir. Initially, when GST came in, they put it on equivalent to Italian marble, sir, which is used in 5-star hotel and 28%. We got it to the notice of the finance minister. He reduced it to 18%. But it's no favor, sir. It was 4% from 28 to 18. Then again, we may get a representation, sir. There, slowly, yes. And now recently, they reduced it to 12. Is it doing justice, sir? From 4%, they increased it to 28 and now reduced to 12%, sir. Great injustice being done, sir. So, on the other hand, Kota stone, which is also a cheap stone from Rajasthan, it costs 30 rupees, it's more expensive than us. And I don't know, maybe they say because the elections are around the corner, Kota stone, the MP is taking credit, sir. So maybe the elections are there very shortly, and that's why Kota stone alone in Rajasthan, they reduced 5%, but not our Thandur stone, sir. But even more things, sir, one is what is just and injustice, but let's talk about ambiguity, sir. We got this to the notice of the Chief Commissioner of State Tax of 2-3 states. These stones are not there in just our Telangana state, sir. So one of them did this, sir. This is to inform the commodity Napa stone whether or not roughly trimmed or merely cut or by sawing or otherwise into blocks or slabs of rectangular including square falls under heading 2515 to attract 5% GST, sir. All others 28%, sir. So he is creating, all others are called tiles, sir. So the same slab, this is a slab, sir. If the commercial tax officer is treated well, sir, it suddenly becomes is not treated well, it becomes a tile. The same thing becomes a slab. So he's introduced ambiguity. Once you introduce ambiguity, it proves, paves way for corruption and various other forms of malpractice in GST, sir. So there are various issues like this, sir. And this Thandur stone, how it's treated, sums up this whole GST business, where neither it simplifies, neither it reduces ambiguity, and neither it reduces fraud, sir. So It takes two to tango, sir. We want to progress, we want the country to progress, and that's why we are cooperating with the government, sir. And we are actually happy a few things about the sanitary napkins, and I need to state that that was anomaly with the government recognized not too quickly. So they reduced the GST, exempted it from GST. But in the state of Telangana, sir, not only there's no tax, very soon there's no cost also, because our CM is going to announce free sanitary napkins to the entire state,
right,
sir.
Right, right, right.
Sir, one more thing, sir. The GST collection, sir, states need to really cooperate. There's a huge gap. We are a growing state, sir. The minister promised to make up for any shortfall in GST collection, sir. But our state is a growing state, sir. We can't base it on yesterday's tax collection. We have to base it on today's tax collection, sir. So we are shortchanged, sir. And also, sir, the timing was really bad, sir. We initiated one of the largest drinking water projects. We initiated irrigation projects.
All that.
And the timing really hit us very, very badly, sir. Sir, give me just a few more minutes, sir. I have quite a few things to cover. I'll try to do it in a short while. So, sir, our GST collections have come down. The difference revenue gap came down to 2.4% by March 18th. Whereas the rest of the country stands currently at 17.5%, sir. So at the same time, sir, there are some contributing states, and we are one of the contributing states, and we are proud to say that we contribute net not just for our growth, but we contribute for the growth. Every Telanganite is proud that he contributes for the growth of the nation, sir. So about sports, sir. Sportsmen, health equipment and all, it's at 28%, sir. And how does it help, sir? Especially we are trying to make a nation very, very healthy, sir. Sir, there's a talk, sir. Now, this is very, very important, sir. Talk about petrol. And this we are really worried, that petrol and alcohol may come under GST, sir. One side you are trying to promote local self-governance and decentralized things. Now, the last frontier of GST is petrol and alcohol. That at least the states have control, sir. Now, if you, we heard about this and we are extremely worried about that, sir. If you are going to do this, definitely, sir, it takes two to tango, but it also takes two to fight, sir. We are not just we, sir. All the states are going to fight for this. But a few more things, sir. Just about apartments under construction. Again, ambiguity, sir. If it's fully constructed, no GST, apartments under construction. Who is it going to hit, sir?
Right.
The middle class people who are taking loans and booking advance, paying an advance, and they buy their apartments much before it's constructed. So they have to pay GST, sir. So many, many, many such anomalies,
right,
sir. And I think these need to be addressed very, very quickly.
Sorry,
thank you once again, sir. Thank you.